way on south there lives a man they call a squire. He tends the land, and I'm a human character, quite happy with his herd.
He's reasonably modest. He's slow to anger, but once he gets, once you give him risen, he can be like any other person, I suppose. He's very frustrating at times.
Backroads high and famous streets, chicken bones and strong heartbeats, as good as when he started, and that legend then occurred about the man who's always coming first.
Derek, for the last 40 years, has been the standard. The standard which people try to aspire, in fact, to beat him.
Farm life, living and the sweet clean air.
Well, he's always been a great motivator to all of us. He's an inspiration.
Derek and I were running in a 10,000 metre race. It was the New Zealand Championships, and we started slowly. Halfway through the race, Derek came up onto my shoulder and he said to me, "I'm stuffed, Mike, I'm going to have to pull out." And two laps later, suddenly he went roaring past me, continued on. I knew I had a race on my hands. I didn't catch him, and he did a time of around 34 minutes 40. Broke the world record for his age group by 2 minutes. Fastest old man in the world.
Tucked away at the bottom of the world in the tiny farming community of Tussock Creek lives the greatest veteran runner of all time. Since 1975, the New Zealand farmer Derek Turnbull has claimed 25 world age group records to become the fastest old man in the world.
John Sisson, farmer. I'm up at 6 most mornings, try and get the wheels turning by 7 and winter by 8. Do a day's work and have a good life on the farm. Busy all the time. That's me. Yes, I like the wide open spaces.
Well, it's a way of life to me because I've been running since 1939 in my first year of high school. I was only a lad of 13 men. So it must be 53 years I've been at it. Starting to get the hang of it now, a wee bit. Training runs. Oh, goodness gracious, I haven't got any. I haven't got a coach, I haven't got a stopwatch, I haven't got any schedule in like that. When I get time, and if I feel like it, I enjoy the camaraderie of my fellow runners. It's a relaxation. It's a great way of getting rid of tension and stress and that. And even milking the cows. So yeah, well, it's a daily chore. It's still quite a pleasant chore on a nice day like this with the sun shining. So running is more or less part of my life, same as farming is.
I love farming because of the challenge to do something better this year than I did last year, to improve the land and leave it in better heart than when I took it over. I'm a third generation Southlander, and all my predecessors have been connected with farming.
Everything we do is running orientated. Even when, before we even married, we used to go out. I always came home alone. Every time, he would run home. We'd go to a dance or pictures or something in town, and I would drive home, wait at the gate for him, and he'd turn up sweaty and hot. And it's a marvel that we that we kept going. And even now, you never go anywhere without a pair of running shoes and the boot.
When we had a 40-month-old girl, we had a sudden addition to the family of three more. I went to bed and forgot to turn the key off. That took a bit of handling, didn't it, Pat? Then 7 years after that, we had two more.
It was the triplets who were creating the headlines in those days. Later, Derek and the six children teamed up in family relays at local track meetings. And then Derek set his sights on the marathon.
The marathon is a special race. It's a challenge to accomplish the training that's necessary to get through a marathon easily. It's different from a short run on the track because you're talking in seconds per mile, not seconds per lap. My first marathon was in 1955, when I'd be 29, I expect. And that was a revival of the first marathon ever held in New Zealand in 1909 on the Riverton to Invercargill course. I was the only starter. There was only one official. That official was the starter. He was the timekeeper. He was the drink steward, paper correspondent. He was everything rolled up in one, and he accompanied me the distance on a push bike. And I can remember that marathon. That was 2 hours, 43 minutes, my first marathon. And even today, with a bit of a push, I can probably still do that.
In 1977, Andy won New Zealand's first veteran gold medal. And just to see him coming down that straight and knowing he was going to win, that was just a wonderful feeling. And I was proud for him, proud for me, and proud for New Zealand. And I think that first medal will always just stay as the highlight.
Gothenburg was followed by a double victory in Hanover with gold in the 1500 and 5000 metres. Back in New Zealand, he gained further gold in the 1500, 5000 and 10000 metres.
Flew out of Invercargill and arrived in Christchurch and got to our hotel, and I looked around, here was Derek sprawled out on the bed, absolutely dead to the world. When I came back, he was still asleep. An hour or so later, we went to QE2 Park. He ran his 5,000 and broke the world record.
In Rome, Derek was named Athlete of the Games with 6 world titles in road and track, including the marathon.
With Derek's running, he finds sometimes that the cow keeps him at home. It's always there to be milked. In fact, he's always telling me that his one big regret is that I don't milk a cow. But gee, if I milked a cow, I'd be forever at home. I just wouldn't get away. He'd be off and I'd be left again. So I refuse to milk the cow.
Derek now entered the 60 to 64 age group, winning another 6 gold medals. He was again Athlete of the Games.
I've known Derek for about 10 years and run with him often during that time. We became particular friends in the Melbourne Games when Derek was competing and I was also there to race. I remember one particular night, my race was on quite late, it was about 9:30, it was a 10,000 metre race, which means running around the track 26 times, and I remember every time I went past Derek, he was there calling and yelling out from the side, and even though he should really have been in bed resting up for his next race, he was out there supporting me and everyone else on our team. So he's always been a great friend in that respect.
Probably I would rate my greatest race as a marathon in Adelaide when I was just turned 60. I'd always had in mind that someday I would break the 2-hour 40 barrier for a 60-year-old because I knew nobody else in the world had done it. 7 degrees Celsius and never got beyond 11 all day. And it was a calm day with just a little bit of drizzle to keep the radiator cool. And everything went well. And I did that in 2:38:47.
And then there was that race in the San Francisco Marathon. I think it was 3,000 in that one, and you were up in the 20-somethings. And I can still see the announcer. He was reading the numbers with his binoculars as people came in the far end, and I heard him say, and here's runner number. He looked at his book, and he looked back, and he looked down his book again. He says, folks, you'll never believe this. And he said, this is Derek Turnbull from New Zealand. And I can still see him doing that, and everybody just stood up and cheered.
In Eugene, Derek again wins 6 gold, missing out in the 5,000 metres when he lost his teeth and had to stop to pick them up. Back-to-back titles followed in the prestigious New York Marathon. On December the 5th, 1991, Derek Turnbull celebrated his 65th birthday, which put him into the next age group and gave him the chance to collect a new set of records. During early 1992, Derek Turnbull ran the greatest race series in the history of Masters competition, breaking every age group record from the 800 to the 10,000 metres. Only the marathon remained to complete the set of world records. 2 hours, 42 minutes, 49 seconds was the time he had to beat, and the London Marathon provided that opportunity.
I'm very, very apprehensive about achieving that time because it is quite a while since I have done a marathon as fast as that. In fact, I haven't done many marathons the last few years. But 4 or 5 years ago, 2 hours 42 was a reasonable time to me. So I'm most apprehensive about doing it.
I passed him on the Roseneath Hill where he was walking. And as I came up to him, I was almost embarrassed to pass him. And he said to me as I went past him, "The distance has got me, Jim." And I thought, "You silly old bugger. Of course the distance has got you. It gets us all." But anyway, as I passed him and came in just ahead of him at the finish, I thought, tremendous, I've beaten him. And then the terrible truth is that you don't like to boast about how you've just thrashed a 65-year-old man in a race.
What is so exceptional about Derek Turnbull isn't all the races he's won or the records he's set, but the fact that he's almost as fast at 65 as he was at 20.
I find it hard to live with a runner. They're a wee bit selfish. One of the other wives rang me up and said, "Well, it's time somebody spoke out, because they're always for the runners." But I'm not alone in thinking that it's a lonely way of life. In fact, I know quite a few couples, especially those with young families, that find it very hard to fit in a runner and cope.
Pat and Derek are very much a team, and I always remember Pat especially for her hospitality. We walk in the door tired and hungry, and invariably there's a table laid out spread with all sorts of goodies that Pat's baked. And as I say, she's very much Derek's manager. I don't think Derek would have got where he has today if it wasn't for Pat.
Pat and I have been married for 36 years now. That's a long sentence, isn't it? You only get 10 years for murder these days. But runners aren't easy to live with, I know that. And it is very difficult for a non-runner and an active runner to be on the same wavelength mentally in that. Pat does a wonderful job organising our overseas trips, tolerating me at home here, washing all my dirty running gear and putting up with a pair of smelly running shoes. Running has given us the opportunity to see a lot of the world, and I hope she regards that as some recompense for the intolerance of a bloke like me.
Runners applied in 1992 for the London Marathon, but only 34,000 were accepted. Very few are invited to run. Derek Turnbull was one of these.
Fitness is half in the mind. If you know you're fit, you can know you can do it. If you know you're not fit, you go into it with doubts and trepidation, and you expect to be running for a wall, and you will. I have done that once or twice. It's usually lack of training as much as anything. But, no, I like American.
We're up on the high ground here, too, probably when we get down on the Plaque.
I think they
said
the rain's only going to last for an hour anyway.
Yeah, the wind will probably get down.
How are you? Oh, you'll love it. You're always smiling anyway.
So how are you feeling this morning?
Good as gold. Looking forward to it. In spite of the cold English morning. But the hour, the temperature will suit me fine.
How long do you think it'll take you?
At no more than 3 hours, perhaps under 250. Yeah, so I can't predict anything with accuracy. So much can go wrong in a marathon. So much can go right sometimes too. So you take it as it comes.
Okay.
I like to run a race if I can. So when I've settled into a position, I can pick them off one at a time or a group at a time. I don't like to be passed, because when you're passed, it's usually by someone who's got a better pace judgment and is usually slower pace in the early stages of the race to better advantage. It's very gratifying to pick them off. Marathon is keep the speed down to the first 10 mile. Even as long ago as 1950, when you had to have a medical certificate in New Zealand to run a marathon, a fellow said to me then, if you gain a minute in the first 10 miles, you'll lose 10 minutes in the last 10 miles. So you've really got to put the brakes on the first 10 miles.
He doesn't worry about winning or losing, but I worry. I worry that he's going to drop dead or something will go wrong. So I usually sit in the back of the grandstand away from everybody else so I can just keep my emotions to myself. I mean, the others all cheer and laugh and everything, but I just sit there quietly usually and just think, oh, good.
Veteran runner Derek Turnbull established a new world marathon mark in the 65 to 69 age group when he won his section of the London Marathon this morning. The 65-year-old Southland farmer broke the old mark set by the legendary American Clive Davies by 52 seconds, recording a time of 2 hours 41 minutes 56. Turnbull now holds the world's best times for the 800, 1500, 3000, 5000 and 10,000 metres, the mile and the marathon. Darren Lutlow, Radio New Zealand Sport.
I'm right now.
What'd you do?
2:41.56.
What?
Yeah.
2:41.
Yep.
Oh, that was
great,
wasn't it?
Boy, she was a screaming star.
Was it? Hey, I'm going to carry it out for you in that case.
I was tired at the finish.
Yeah.
I've recovered now, though.
Yeah. Oh, dear. You looked a bit haggard as you came past the embankment there.
And I was tired. Yeah.
Oh, dear. It's just miserable.
I'm proud of what he's done. I think it's fantastic what he's achieved. And I hope he keeps running for the rest of his life. People retire, but he'll never retire, and I wouldn't want him to. And we've had lots of trips away. They've been the bonus, I think. But then you've got to have a few bonuses to make up for the things that you don't do.
I'll just keep on running as long as I can, as long as there's breath in me, as long as I enjoy it. As long as there's a challenge somewhere, because there's three rules that I believe in. One is there must be an enjoyment in the running. Secondly, I never give up, and I give that advice to anybody. And thirdly, I never enter a race that I know I can't finish.
Way on south there lives a man they call a squire. He tends the land and an issuing character, quite happy with his herd. He may be getting on in years, but he's got respect from all his peers. Three cheers, he's the fastest old man in the world. Back roads high and famous streets, chicken bones and strong heartbeats as good as when he started. And that legend then occurred about the man who's always coming first. Black Mac Bear will quench the thirst. Oh yes, he's the fastest old man in the world. Farm life, living and the sweet clean air. See him out running around everywhere. Where's he gonna be next? No one knows. With his old running shoes on and on and on and on he goes. Finish lines around the globe. Broken records, trophy shows, this dedicated champion.
The weather's right. I go for a run on the road or out across country or up in the hills there. Those hills are in the background there. And that's relaxation to me. A day out in the hills, come home to a good meal and a few beers, it's like living in paradise.